Hey friends, thank you guys so much for watching. Today I have a new drugstore makeup haul and review. I went to Target and CVS a couple months ago and I've been saving these products to test out for you guys. I have some demos and swatches with this whole like mini review series. I hope you guys like it, so let's go ahead and get started. So the very first thing I want to talk about are the Sonia Kashuk brushes. I bought them maybe a month ago at Target and I think the whole pack was like under $15. So I was like, wow, that's a great pack. But then I like some of the brushes, like the foundation brush works very well. And then some of the brushes I didn't really like the eyeshadow brushes, I didn't feel like it blended very well. Sorry, I don't have all of them to show you. Some of them are dirty and I'm washing them and they're wet. Also, a lot of the brushes, they shed more than they should. So I will use it because I think it's trash day. Oh my gosh, it is trash day. Sorry, you guys. The trash man's here to collect our trash, and so you guys hear that sound. Anyhow, like I was saying, you know, like I will continue using them, but they're not my favorite brushes. So if you don't like shedding, this is probably not the makeup brush for you. I recently bought the Revlon Photo Ready Airbrush Mousse Makeup Foundation. The color I use is golden beige, and I really like this foundation. So when I put it on, it was so lightweight and it felt like I barely had makeup on. And I don't know, when my husband saw me with this foundation, he noticed something different, like right away. He goes, wow, your skin looks flawless. And I mean, like, dang, if he's gonna say that, I'm gonna go ahead and buy all of these at the store, you know what I mean? So I love the coverage. I love that it creates like this flawless, no pore finish. But in the sun, I went in the sun and I looked at my face without any setting powder. My face looked really shiny. So if you have oily skin or if you don't like that oily, shiny look, you really need to put on a setting powder. I feel like this isn't good alone, but it's great with a setting powder. And the setting powder I love to use with it is the Revlon Photo Ready. And in addition to that, I don't find that this foundation is long lasting. So to me, it's like an event makeup or something that I would wear like with a lot of powder on top, but it just doesn't last long. Like I was wearing it all day and my nose was shiny. So I'm kind of like torn because I love the flawless finish, but I don't like the fact that it doesn't even last long. Even with a primer, even with setting powder, it didn't last long. So I'm kind of 50-50, but I'm still gonna continue using it because I do like the flawless finish. So maybe this is like event makeup or even filming makeup when, like, you know, I just need that flawless finish look. I've had this a while. It's the Wet n Wild Sugar Coat 205B nail polish. It's actually the nail polish I wear all the time. And every time I wear it, everyone's like, ooh, what nail polish are you wearing? And I'm like, I am wearing Sugar Coat, and it's from Wet n Wild. And they're like, whoa, really? And I'm like, yeah, really. It's a great color. You need about 3 coats for it to be opaque. But if you like, you know, that sheer coat, see-through look, you can just do 1 coat. I find that it doesn't really last for a week. It kind of chips at the top and on the bottom of the nails, but if you have a good top coat, it'll last you a good week. But overall, it's a great color and you can't really ask for much. I mean, it's 99 cents, so I like it because of the color. I saw this at CVS. It's a CoverGirl blush and it's called Clean Glow Blusher 100 Roses. And this color, actually, when I was filming the demo, the color doesn't really show much on my skin tone. I don't know, but it kind of looks more like a bronzer color than a blush. I actually like it. It's very natural looking, but I notice I do have to pack on a lot of color, so there's not a lot of pigmentation. There's not really good color payoff on this. I do like the color, but I do wish that the product itself had more color payoff and that I didn't have to like beat my face with it to put the blush on. So this is definitely not a pigmented blush, but the color works very well on my skin tone. But I probably wouldn't repurchase any more of these just because I feel like they need more pigmentation and more color payoff. For a long time, everybody and their mama, their daddy, their grandpa, their aunt, they were all talking about the Rimmel London Show Off Lip Liqueur. And I got the color in 102 Nova. And oh my goodness, this glides on like so beautifully on your lips. It's so pigmented, and it even leaves a stain on your lips even after you kind of like wipe it off. I think that it's one of the like most long lasting lip product. It's not a gloss, it's like a liquid lipstick instead of a gloss. And the thing is, I probably would like it. I mean, the color payoff is bananas, but it has a smell. And you guys, sometimes when I use lip products, if there's a smell, it's over. I can't handle it. I don't even know how to describe it. It smells like flower disgustingness, and it's not nice flowers. I'm so sorry. A lot of you guys probably like it, and you guys are like, what the heck, April, what's wrong with you? I just don't like it. I actually picked this up at Walgreens. It's the Jordana LOL Lip Out Loud Super Shiny Gloss, and I got it in 109. BTW, by the way. That's a cute name. Anyhow, I put this on my lips and it's super moisturizing, super shiny. Like, if you like that shiny lip, this is awesome, and it's so inexpensive. And it smells kind of like watermelons, and there's no color payoff. It's just pretty much clear with a slight hint of like a peachy color, but it's more for shine. So you can actually use this on top of lipstick if you like that shiny look. I definitely recommend it. It has a good scent. I'm all about scents. It's moisturizing. It's super shiny. I wanted to try this for a long time. It's the L'Oreal Magic Nude Liquid Powder, and I've actually tested this for weeks, like one or two times a week. I'll be wearing this foundation. When you apply it on, it's very runny, so you have to be careful, because like, I'm the type of person who likes to put on my foundation on my hand, but I noticed when I did that, it was like running on my hand and just going everywhere. It's such a liquidy foundation. It's not thick at all. So I think the packaging could have had a pump, or it could have been a formula with a little bit more creaminess to it, so that it wouldn't... Can you guys hear that? It's so liquidy. Anyhow, when you put it on your skin, it is first like a foundation, and then it dries to a powder velvety like finish. I actually like the powdery finish, and I actually do like this foundation. It's a great foundation. The coverage is not high, or it's not really good coverage. It's kind of like medium coverage, and even though you can put as much as you want, I don't really see like a full coverage. It's like a natural feeling, and for the girls and guys who don't have like oily skin, you can get away with just wearing this. But since I have oily skin, I like to set it with powder. I use this eyeliner all the time, and I don't even know why I never talked about it. It is the Milani Liquid-like eyeliner pencil. So it is a liner, and it looks like liquid, but it is not. It's like a cream liner or a pencil liner, and it just glides on so beautifully. It glides on beautifully on top of the lash line, and it's so good for tight lining for your inner rim. Oh, actually, my previous tutorial, my natural makeup look, I did a tutorial with this, and it just glides on like butter. It is fantastic. I recommend it if you guys are looking for a really smooth eyeliner to put on your waterline. I mean, it's so hard to, you know, tight line your eyes when like that, when your eyeliner is like so hard and it smudges, but this is like butter. It's like whoop, and you're good to go. I recommend it to you guys. I saw this on an end cap at CVS. They had like the model with the gorgeous false lashes. It's so funny that mascara ads always use like models with fake lashes. That's totally false advertisement. Anyhow, this is the mascara, and it's called the Falsies Big Eyes, and the most interesting part about this is the top is for your top lashes, and then the bottom is for your lower lashes. I find that the top lash mascara is not really my favorite. I mean, it gets the job done, it volumizes a little bit, there's no lengthening that I notice, but the bottom lashes mascara is pretty awesome. I think that it separates well, and it's like the perfect little size for your little lashes. It's adorable. So I'm kind of 50-50 on this, because I like the lower lash mascara, the top not so much, so I probably wouldn't repurchase this, but it was fun trying it, and I will continue using it just because I'm the type of person who doesn't like to waste product. This is a repeat purchase. It's the Wet n Wild Creme Brulee eyeshadow. It's my favorite little cream looking shadow or nude shadow that I like to put on my brow bone. When you apply it on your brow bone, it just defines it a little bit more. And I'm the type of person who's really lazy. I rarely get my eyebrows done. I like to get them threaded, but sometimes I don't have time, and sometimes I don't even like pluck them. I mean, you guys have seen my tutorials. Like, my eyebrows are never on point. But the thing is, when I use this, it kind of hides the little stray hairs that I have, and it just makes my brow bone look more put together, if that makes any sense at all. And the color payoff is fantastic. I definitely recommend this little Wet n Wild eyeshadow. The last thing I want to mention is a hair product. This is Palmer's Coconut Oil Formula. It's a deep conditioning protein pack. I got 3 of these. That's why this is the new packaging. It smells fantastic. And after you put on the mask, I shower and I like will dry my hair. And my hair feels soft that I just like want to touch my hair. It does feel similar to my mask that I make at home. It's a DIY mask that I use coconut oil. I'll have the video where I share with you guys how to do your own DIY hair mask. It feels similar. So I don't know if I would repurchase this just because I can make my own. But if you guys are not a DIYer, you guys don't like to make stuff, definitely give this a try because it makes your hair feel so soft and it smells so good. So thank you friends so much for watching my drugstore haul and review. I hope that you enjoyed the demos. Let me know what product you guys like the most and let me know any drugstore requests that you guys have because I plan to make this a regular thing. I call it drugstore haul and review. It's like my favorite video to film, you guys. So if you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, I would appreciate a thumbs up, like if you like the video. I'll see you in my next video. And if you can, I would love, love, love it if you guys checked out my cooking channel, Cook with April, and my vlog, April Justin TV. Till then, I will see you guys next time. Bye. She packaged it so pretty with bubble wrap so that it doesn't break. Oh my goodness. She got me a cat.